She's my wife, man. She's my wife. That is my wife, man. You're picking him over me. You're picking him over me now.
Wow, what you're seeing there, that's Kevin King. He's trying to talk to his wife, but he's being manhandled by his wife's alleged lover. King and his wife, they end up divorced, but then he sued the man, Francisco's his name, by the way, and Kevin King, the husband, won to the tune of almost $9 million. He's sued under a little-known law. It's the Alienation of Affection Law. Bottom line, ruling from the judge here, you sleep with another man's wife, ruin the marriage, break up the family, you're going to pay a price. Let's go to our lawyers to debate this one. Joey Jackson is with us, HLN legal analyst, great criminal defense attorney. Bob Bianchi's with us as well, former prosecutor and a defense attorney. All right, Joey, there's the bottom line ruling, and they have a little daughter, 5-year-old, the family's broken apart. You think this is a good ruling or not?
Are you asking me to put my lawyer hat on,
yes,
my humanity hat on,
yes,
or my common sense
all
hat
of the
on,
above,
my dear friend Mike? Listen, here's the point. Nice to be with you and Triple B, bad as in incredibly good, Bob Bianchi. The point is that there is such a law. The law provides for, in the event that you have a happy situation and you have an interloper who comes and they, for whatever reason, impair that happy situation, and as a result, they're broken up, you are allowed to sue. Now, this is one of only 6 jurisdictions in the United States that provide for this. But what I am a proponent of, Mike, is using laws in a way that are beneficial to get the relief that you request. And so, while I would not advocate for such a law to exist in the 50 states, to the extent that it does exist in this state, I believe that he availed himself of it appropriately. And I believe the relief that he was afforded was the proper call by the judge in this case.
There you go. Bob, it's the law. How are you arguing it?
Hey, Triple J, Justice Joey Jackson is a great lawyer, and you just saw it on display. This law is archaic. It goes back to the English common law, where women were considered chattel or property of the man. And the Kentucky Supreme Court recently said you cannot own a person's love and affection. Obviously, the relationship wasn't going well, or she wouldn't have, quote unquote, stepped out. And then I have to ask this question. $8.8 million. Where did the judge come up with this one? This is the 2018. That law should be struck down as unconstitutional. It is trying to force marriage and people to stay in marriages that they don't want to be in. And while I appreciate Justice Joey Jackson's argument, I say this law is retarded.
Ooh. I say, Mike, we have to keep our eye on the prize. My esteemed colleague appoints and looks to a ruling in Kentucky as persuasive authority. May I remind all viewers that we are in the state, the fine state where my son goes to school, of North Carolina, and in this state it provides and allows for it. And while I would never, ever presume or want to think that women would be chattel, that is property, women have minds of their own as men do, they're independent thinkers, the law provides for either a woman or a man to avail themselves of this statute to prevent someone else from coming forward and alienating the affections. Use the law, use it wisely, keep marriages together, and $8.8 million, that's the price you pay for wrecking up a relationship.
Hey, guys, let's listen to, this is the husband, Kevin King, and I believe his attorney, as they're laying out, he goes back to 2015, sees text messages, Facebook posts, phone records, hotel receipts, and he looks at the phone number he's not familiar with, and he calls Francisco and says, back off. Here's Kevin King, the husband.
I called from her phone, so obviously he thought it was her calling. So when he answered, I simply said, she is a married woman. Do not contact her ever again.
On separate occasions, one in particular, she announced to her friends and on social media that she wanted to save her marriage. And the evidence was that rather than just moving on and accepting that, that Mr. Pizar continued to pursue her.
Bob, there you go. Francisco, no respect for marriage and family. And he's paying a price. Go ahead.
I feel bad for the guy. Don't get me wrong. And I would have had the same exact conversation. But that woman who gave that soundbite where she was like overwhelmed and overpersuaded by Francisco, hey, she's got a mind of her own, too. She can make her decisions. And if that marriage was so good, she wouldn't have stepped out in the first place. And the bottom line is, this can be used as extortion or blackmail, that if you fall in love with another person and you're married, you cannot pursue that because you have to worry about some judge who gets a ridiculous $8.8 million. Even Justice Joey Jackson would have to say, even if it's lawful to do, you can't justify $8.8 million. People get in car accidents, die, have their limbs ripped off, get blinded, deaf, neurocognitive injuries, and they don't get that kind of money. Come on, it's crazy.
And on that point, Francisco, he makes like $91,000 a year. He's appealing, but Joey, it's the law. I mean, do you think, how much is he going to end up paying, you think?
I think, to be fair, in my advocacy, I think at the end of the day, it will be modified on an appeal. There is a lot wrong with this statute, to be clear. There are, as my esteemed colleague mentioned, Triple B, Bad Bob Bianchi, some constitutional issues involved. And look, at the end of the day, if you make $91,000, your judgment proof as it relates to $8.8 million. So it's more of a Pyrrhic victory, to be sure.
Got it. All right. Triple J, Triple B, guys, thanks again.
Bob, you moved me over a little to your position. See, that's how persuasive you are, right?
He certainly did.
Well, I love you, Joey.
On the appeal.
Guys, thanks again. Appreciate it.
Always. Right.